So he was.
Yes, I think if we, that people are just going to go to Mexico and buy the seed. I mean, if I was still manufacturing, I'm not even going to play around with the little boxes here in town. I'm going to go to the border where it's legal, where I can buy a large quantity for a cheap price.
The same as taking the P2P off the market where people can't get it. I think it'll reduce it. And some, just like they took that off the market.
And then they come up with anhydrous.
Yeah.
I mean, you're gonna reduce the manufacture of a pseudo ephedrine-based product. And like Rhonda said, they could go up there. You can go to Canada. You can go either way and get tons of it. But not, you know, with drug addiction, your more mindset is local. That's why you get busted seven times in the same neighborhood.
Yeah. Back in the day before the ephedrine drugs, we'd make it out in the country in real isolated areas.
Right.
Where,
and lots of it.
Yeah,
you make a lot of it.
That's what I'm saying.
You didn't make small batches back then.
You made at least a few.
So now you have corner store,
You got amateur kids that are just learning from what they hear from hearsay how to make it. Yeah. And they're the ones that are blowing themselves up and hurting themselves.
Yeah.
It's the real cooks. Don't make mistakes. Don't chance. They know what they're doing.
Exactly.
I think there's a lot of people that are out there cooking to support their habit. It's just they're cooking to use.
Mm-hmm.
See, so those ones that are cooking to use, they're not running to the border.
Yeah. One part of my sentence was that I can no longer buy pseudoephedrine pills.
Right.
So that makes it a lot easier for me because I've been doing it since I was so young.
Mm-hmm.
That makes it a lot easier for me to focus on my recovery because I know I can't just go to the corner store and buy new pseudoephedrine pills.
Who here would agree with this statement? If you really want to deal with meth, don't mess with the manufacturing. Make treatment more available and free.
I think you need both.
Oh, absolutely.
Absolutely.
But I still think you need both. I still think you need to put the...
I think you need both, too.
Yeah.
Take the pills away and do the extra treatment. Yeah.
How much do you spend an incarcerated person in a year? And how much would you save had you sent them to treatment at least once? To see if it worked. I mean, if you spend $10,000 on treatment and it works, you just save $25,000.
Drug court is too hard. They want too much.
They want you to fail.
They want you to fail. Drug court is just, it's ridiculous. How are you supposed to go to all them classes and work and take care of your kids and go to your kids' school, stuff like that. Like, us at the Exodus House, we go to work and we go to programs, but it's time manageable.
Drug court is a punishment, and how are you going to punish a disease? If addiction is a disease, why is it okay to punish it? We need to cure the disease, and we need inpatient help available at an affordable or free. It's still going to be a lot cheaper than the penitentiaries.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, treatment, you can go to treatment. But if you get out and go back to your same neighborhood, your chances are 100% about that you're going to use.
Yeah.
Unless we start applying some of the simple principles that we're learning in AA and NA is change your playground, change playmates, change everything about you.
How can the state break you out of the environment without sending you to prison?
It comes down to your own choice. What worked for me was I had come from Sequoia County, but when I got out of prison, I came to Exodus House in Tulsa, and I've never went back to my hometown.
Right.
I changed everything. My playmates, my playgrounds, and the basic principles that you learn in the AA.
All my family, my kids, and everything are in Lawton, but I had to make the choice to...
That's right.
To move where I could be safe at and where I could work on my recovery at. And the Exodus House gives me the opportunity to do that. Without them, I would probably have went right back to using drugs.
Jesus, but if I'd have stuck around my playground, I would have got high. And I called and I made the phone call and I came to Tulsa and I've been here ever since.
Yeah.
And I give it because I changed my playmates. I changed my playthings. I changed my playgrounds. It's so important.
Mm-hmm.
And the system in the state can't make that personal choice for you. But if addicts out there know that if it worked for us, it can work for them.
Yes.
And you know what? We, most of us are volunteers.